Hello everyone, welcome to the United Stand. I hope you're all doing very, very well. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer seems to have pushed away the threat of losing his job at Manchester United. Quite rightly, many of us would say, but Pochettino to Manchester United scrapped is the headline. And this is coming from, look, I think it needs to be said. It's very, very obvious. In some ways, I've always liked Pochettino. I do like him. I've always said I wasn't sure about him coming to United as manager, even though a lot of people felt that was going to happen. Some people even think it still could happen. But I was always a bit concerned about Pochettino, about his lack of width. And I do like width. And I know we shouldn't live in the past, but I do like United to use width. I always have. And Pochettino never really did that at Spurs. And I do feel sorry for Pochettino, though, because I think he's a likable guy. And look, we know the situation worldwide. We know football's been suspended. But where does that leave Pochettino? Because I think there would have been jobs available in the summer if things had carried on as usual. Maybe there might have been a job for him at Manchester United, but certainly other clubs. But with the league and the world football suspended, where does that leave people like Pochettino and Allegri in the summer? You know, clubs are going to have to make somewhat brave decisions to go, yeah, we don't think you're good enough. I mean, you look at Real Madrid, there was even talk of a job being there, but you know, you never know what Zidane was going to do against Man City in the second leg or in La Liga. So why would you sack him? So I think those managers that, you know, maybe were primed to, oh, I might have Bayern Munich, I might have this, I might have that, they're suddenly in that situation where, well, you might not have that because the season hasn't been completed. So how does this fit in with Manchester United? Look, Pochettino was a target for Manchester United. Everybody was discussing it in January. It was quite clear that talks had taken place between Pochettino and the club. That's not unusual. United will spend a lot of time and will have spent a lot of time between January and now talking to players that won't even sign for us, so talking to managers that won't come to us. It's part of the game. I don't think Ole Gunnar Solskjaer would be surprised about that, especially when in January, before the second coming of Bruno and Igalo, there was that feeling that Ole may be heading towards the door. In fact, some people still, as I say, feel that that could have been a possibility. With Solskjaer now, that... How could you, I mean, I want to talk about that in a minute, but how could you sack Solskjaer? Even if you're a Solskjaer out person, how could you sack Solskjaer now? Not because he's had 11 games unbeaten and we're playing well, but more because it's a massive jump into the unknown, isn't it? I think my mindset was always, let's wait till May, and May being the end of the season, let's see whether we've qualified for Champions League football. We can't wait till May now. So if you're asking me, do we get rid of Ole now and get Pochettino now? Or in the summer when we've not... Now is May, isn't it? Now is June. Now could be August. Where we are now, with that last game against Linz and that last Man City game in the league, that could be our last game till August. Or June. Or May. Or April. Who knows? So if it is, and Pochettino's there in the summer with his hand up saying, do you want me for manager? How can you make that decision? Because you don't know what would have happened. If we get top four, if we had got top four, you'd be like, thanks, but no thanks, maybe. If we didn't, you'd be like, please come. But how can you make that decision when you don't know what it is? Manchester United have made that decision because whilst interest with Pochettino was there, whilst talks clearly obviously did take place, their situation is that United have scrapped those plans because they can't make that jump that I can't make, that many of you can't make. So Pochettino to United, and there are still people out there without naming names who have said and were saying a few weeks ago, and some of them have gone quiet, but some of them are still saying it, that Pochettino to United is done no matter what happens. Ollie's gone in the summer no matter what happens, Pochettino's coming in. I've never believed that, I've never been told that, I've got no reason to believe that. I can only go on the stuff that we hear, and what we're hearing is, and a couple of other people have spoken about it over the last 24 hours as well, is that United have shelved plans for a new manager in the summer, specifically Pochettino. So where he goes... Second time, maybe there'll be a third time for Pochettino, third time lucky, but first time last summer, we stuck with Ole. Second summer, where he is really available, we're going to be sticking with Ole. So Pochettino, shelved, scrapped, whatever. And, you know, he is a victim like many, in a footballing sense here. I'm not talking about life and everything like that in the bigger picture. We're a football channel. In a footballing sense, he is a major victim of what's going on with this suspension of football, because lots of teams will not finish their season normally, so they won't know what decision to make. And I think a lot of clubs are going to be sticking instead of twisting in the summer. And I think this will feed nicely into the transfer window, which I want to talk about as well, because if you're signing players in the summer, how do you do that now when a season's not been completed? Do you just think... And also the financial crisis it's going to cause. Manchester United share price is plummeting. money is dropping. Will we be in the Champions League like I spoke about last night? Like how can we compensate for that? So that feeds into that, doesn't it? But with regards to the manager situation, where do you sit on this? What do you think about this now? Is it, because to me, I like to see both sides and I like to read the comments and see what people are saying. But for me, as somebody who after the Burnley game was like, we probably need to sack him now, he's no good. And even 3 weeks ago, I was saying, look, give him till May. I'm not convinced long term he's the right man, but let's see where we are. That's me. That's my opinion. I'm not going to hide from that. I mean, I think Ollie's now been provided with very good players and that is making his job a lot easier, but you've still got to coach them and we are doing quite well at the moment. Would we have got top four? Will we still get top four when the season starts again, if it starts again? And I still think that's up in the air. And I think this break actually hinders us. I think, you know, one of the things that a lot of people haven't said that's in my head is we spoke about on the chart show this morning about the player momentum. You know, your people like your Luke Shaws who've been playing really well, your Matic's, will they be playing well when we restart? Because you lose momentum, don't you? You get into a vein of form. And I think that's something that, as if we do see the season starting again, will we have the momentum of before it? I mean, let's take, for example, if we'd played Spurs, they wouldn't have had Son, Kane and Bergwijn. When we play Spurs again, they could have all three of those players back. All right, we've got Pogba and Rashford, but they've got three of their players back. So momentum may not be the same. It could flip. We could look, hypothetical here, if the season starts again in May, who's to say Spurs won't go and win their last 9 games because they've suddenly got a strong squad again? It's a reset button. Norwich could have gone win 9 games, which they were never going to do. So you just, it could help people and hinder people. And it'll be interesting to see if we do start the season again, do we get top four? Because just to those people who want Pochettino, whilst the talks with Pochettino have been shelved and we may never, ever end up with Pochettino as manager ever now, what if the season starts again in May? We lose a few games, we don't get top four. There's nothing to say that Ollie won't get sacked in June and Pochettino comes in. But as of now, I think the club, if this season's going to get cancelled for 6 months, cancelled altogether, suspended, whatever, we might not see any football till November, who knows? If that's the situation and you see a new season start, you've got to keep Ollie as manager, in my opinion, because it would be very, very unfair. Some people would say, yeah, but we're still on course for our worst ever Premier League total. But some people would say we've just been on an 11. Since we've brought in the quality number 10, Bruno Fernandes, since we've brought in a striker that can help out and share the burden with Martial, we have looked like a team that can win every single game. And we do look very strong. So it would be wrong. It would be wrong. And I think Manchester United are right here. They are right to shelve those talks with Pochettino, which were taking place. United were looking for managers. And I think now they've got to draw a line under it and go for Solskjaer. And some, as I say, some people would find that a little bit unfair. But that this is the world situation in relation to football is unfair. We won't see a Champions League. We won't see a Europa League. We're not going to see the Euros. We might not see the end of the Premier League. We don't know what we're going to see. So you need a bit of clarity. And I think Manchester United need to look at that. But to say that the world of football is on a pause is to speak absolutely frankly true. I said a few days ago that I would like to see the Premier League suspended. Because of, I think it needs suspending for a few weeks, maybe in a couple of months. But why don't we open up the transfer window just to keep some interest in football? Because the thing about football is that it never sleeps. Like, we as football fans never sleep, but football never sleeps. Your Ed Woodwards, your Real Madrids, your Arsenals, your Ole Gunnar Solskjaers, your Zinedine Zidane's, your PSGs, they don't just go, we're off on holiday. Well, where are you going to go for a start? Because you don't want to go on holiday anywhere at the moment. But even in the summer or the winter breaks, there's transfer windows, there's things to be doing. There is now so much uncertainty. And I don't think we're in a situation where, as much as I wanted us to open the transfer window now just to keep some interest, how can you open a transfer window? Like, how could you open a transfer window? Because who knows what money people have got? They're all about to lose a load of money. It basically is shut down of football. It's really depressing, but the situation bigger is far more serious. But in relation to football, it is shut down time. It is shut down, lockdown. You know, it's not like you can go and do an Adidas tour if you're Paul Pogba because you can't do big gatherings. It's not like you can go and let's get the Sancho deal done now because you can't commit £100 million to Dortmund. Dortmund would probably go, give us the money because financially we're in trouble, and United are like, we can't commit to that. You could see a total collapse of the transfer market. The ramifications are massive, or not. We could see the Premier League back at the start of April. And have no doubts about this. The Premier League suspension, the Champions League suspension, the Europa League suspension. This is not football organisations just going, oh yeah, just shut it down. As long as you want, shut it down. There will be a point, certainly in April, where their pressure is going into the government saying, we need to open this back up. We're losing millions of pounds. Like, we are losing money. And they are business. And they are brand... You know, the sponsors attached to these things who will probably ask to be reimbursed. Who knows? The wider financial situation is huge. And I think I was a little bit naive, and I apologise. I have said on a couple of shows this week, yeah, let's just suspend football for a couple of months. Let's start it again in May. And in the meantime, let's open the transfer window to keep it interesting. How could anybody commit any money at the moment? And I think that goes back to what I was saying at the start. How can anybody commit money to Solskjaer? How can anybody commit to sacking Solskjaer to bring Pochettino in? It would be one of the... And also, that layer is very important as well. For those people who still want to believe, no matter what, Solskjaer's gone and Pochettino's coming in the summer, it made no sense anyway. Like, that stance made no sense to me. And to be honest with you, it was quite rife. There was a lot of people saying it. Now, granted, it was being said around February when we were on the winter break and a lot of people weren't sure about whether we could go on a decent run, as we have. But there was a lot of people saying, Pochettino's coming in no matter what. Don't care what anyone says. I've been told this. This is going to happen. And I think what's actually happened there is, probably knowing the way Manchester United works, and it does have a lot of leaks, and you know, some of those leaks do come from players and stuff like that as well. So we've got to be aware there's a lot of people involved in the wheel of Manchester United. And I think a lot of whispers about Pochettino were coming out from the club that, you know, it's not looking good for Ollie. Pochettino talks, etc. And then somewhere along the line, people have turned that into, no matter what happens, Pochettino is going to come to United. And that clearly, I just don't see how, as I've said before, I don't see how that was ever going to be the situation. Because if you commit to Pochettino's coming in no matter what if Ollie gets third place, wins the Europa League and wins the FA Cup? Oh, sorry, Ollie, you're off. Ollie's like, well, what? WTF? I've just won the Europa League, I've got us top four, and I've won the FA Cup, and we're playing good football, and you're sacking me as well. Yeah, off you go. You see what I mean? This is what I said at the time. How can people be saying, no matter what, we're replacing Ollie with Poch? It was impossible if Ollie achieves. And I don't think Ollie was ever going to win the Europa League, the FA Cup, and get top four, but actually, the form we're in at the moment, probably not going to win the FA Cup because Man City are in it. Having said that, we can beat them. Europa League was winnable. And you never know. You never know. Top four was there. So maybe it could have happened. So that decision about Pochettino was never going to happen. But look at this other layer. Let's take another layer off the onion for those people who are probably crying that Pochettino won't be manager. Never say never. But I think, you know, because of the situation, I think we've got to just accept that United are going to stick with Solskjaer. But let's just look at one of the most pertinent things as well. Manchester United are a business. They are a business, they are businessmen, they like money. The situation at Manchester United is thus. For the last year, we've lost money from not being in the Champions League. We don't know we're in the Champions League next year. If the season gets cancelled, we might be back in the Europa League because we might have to replay the season. So that's more lost money for Manchester United. On top of that, the massive financial crash we are actually enduring at the moment and is going to get worse, why would United go, We're sacking you, Ollie. Pochettino come in on bigger wages and there's a transfer budget. From a financial decision, and we are a football club that isn't run like a football club, we're run like a financial business. Solskjaer's here for next season anyway because he deserves to be at the moment, but also from a business point of view, no way. No way are they going to pay a manager off to pay a new manager to give him a massive transfer budget. It's just outlay. Outlay on a whim. It's just not going to happen, is it? It's just not going to happen. The only way, and I like to be even-handed, the only way Pochettino gets the job at Manchester United this summer is if football starts back again in April or May, the season gets completed, and we end up with our worst Premier League finish, no Champions League football, and no trophies. And in that way, maybe things would happen. But I wouldn't bet on that happening. I don't think we'll get football back that soon. We may get a cancelled league. and in them cases Solskjaer stays. But as I said at the start, as of this moment in time, Pochettino to United, no matter how far along the road you want to believe it was, and as I said, some people believe it was pretty much a done deal, shelved, put into the light, you know, if we're on a road, they've pulled into the services and they're having a meal deal, because at the moment that has been shelved. It's that journey is not going to be completed. And you can't argue about that. You can't argue about that. And I think in this time of, you know, taking the foot off the pedal on football, you do have to look at those wider things. And I think that's some of the stuff we will be looking at over the coming days and weeks in relation to where United are going from here. The great thing is we do have an evidential log of Solskjaer's start, middle and up to this point. We do have this graph of decisions need to be made on that. And I have and always will be critical of the United board, because I think they have made a lot of mistakes. But I think on this, the shelving of Pochettino is common sense. I don't really care about the financials, but they will. On a footballing level, it is common sense to shelve any plan for Pochettino at the moment and long term based on where we are at the moment. Unless we get a season back and we see a conclusion of that season that's not satisfactory, then you might make a decision there. But for now, if Pochettino's saying, look, I want a job in the summer, and this is important as well, we talk about Pochettino as if he's like begging for the United job, and he may well be, but remember what we said, we didn't want a manager who was begging for the job, like Mourinho did, like Van Gaal did, like Moyes did. The next United manager, you wanted the club to be begging them. We're not in that situation where we would be doing that. But also, with Pochettino, he ain't going to be sat there going, I'll wait and see. If he says, I want a job in the summer, are you going to give it me? United right now have got to make the no decision, because there's too much unknown with what we're doing. What if this is it? And I know football can change very, very quickly. It can change very, very, very quickly. And there's no doubting that this wider situation has put a weird situation into play. But if you, as a chairman of Manchester United or a CEO, were in charge of that decision now, and you said, Ollie, you're gone, Poch, you're coming in, you'll never know what could have been. And what if Pochettino, after a year, is getting us fourth and he can't do any more than that? You're going to have fans saying, why did you get rid of Ollie? It looked like we might have done something there. They've got to go down that path, is what I'm saying. Which is funny, because 2 months ago I would have said, maybe we press the exit button. But football can change, and I think Bruno Fernandes has had a massive part on that. I mean, I don't think Pochettino will wait either. I mean, I mentioned Bayern Munich, maybe PSG, probably not Real Madrid, but there will be jobs. There's probably jobs right now that Pochettino can say yes to, that the United job isn't a job he can say yes to, and those talks, as we're hearing, have been shelved in relation to Pochettino, which, to be honest, I think is the right thing. I don't know what you lot think. Get your comments in below in relation to that. Also, just want to say as well, there is no match Sunday for Spurs. Obviously that has been called off, but links in the video description for That's Football. That's my channel where I do Football Manager and FIFA. I'm starting a brand new, for this suspension period, a brand new Manchester United FIFA career mode. And I'm going to start it on Sunday afternoon when the match would have been on. So get in the video description and subscribe. I'll open up that stream at some point tomorrow lunchtime so you can get in the live chat and everything. And that's what we'll be doing, because it's got to go on. We've got to go on, haven't we? And we've got to have a bit of fun. And we've got to try and get through this. So, look, I can't offer you real Premier League football, but I can offer you a little bit of entertainment. And we're going to need it. We're going to need it over the coming weeks. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Get your thoughts in below. Are United right to shelve Pochettino talks and stick with Ollie? Should they still be, like, unsure? Can you even be unsure in an uncertain world? Have you got to just go, look, you know, scenario-based, we'll just have to leave it there, Poch? Or are you one of those people who still thinks, sod it, get rid of Ollie and get Pochettino in? Which I think would be just... Surely you can't be thinking that. You know, surely you've got to look at the last 11 games and say, let's see where that takes us. Thanks everyone for watching. Smash a like on the video. Subscribe if you're new. And I will speak to you soon.